Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to run lex and yacc programs in Windows 10. So before going to this video, it will be really great if you subscribe to my channel. It's absolutely free and it takes no time. And thanks for doing that. So for running our lex and yacc programs, we need flex and bison. So these two softwares enables us to run these programs. So first we need to download and install them. So just go to Google and type flex 2.5.4a. That's the standard version, I guess. And bison 2.4.1 download. Just type this keywords and you'll be getting large number of websites that you can go and download. Like it has GitHub, it has sourceforge.net. I think sourceforge.net is good and it's working, I guess. Many don't work, but I think this one is working. Just go to the here and you will get the setup file, and same thing with bison. Just go to this sourceforge.net and you will have the setup program as well as here. Just same thing, I already installed it, so I don't want to repeat that and I don't want to waste your time. It's the same thing. And during the download installation process, you need to specify the same location for both your flex and bison. Okay, so after downloading, you need to go to this folder. Okay, you will be getting a folder known as GNU Win32. Okay, after downloading, installing flex and bison, you need to do it in the same folder as I told you earlier. You need to go to bin. Okay, and you will have like flex and bison application over there. What you need to do now is this is after installation. Okay, you need to go and copy this path. Okay, cgnu win32/bin. You need to copy this path. And you need to go to environmental variable. Okay, just click open and you need to go to this one and you need to add a path. Okay, you need to just go here and edit it and just go to new and paste it and plus okay. Okay, so I already added it. As you can see, I've already added it, so you can just add over here cgnu win32 new path and just click okay. Okay, so that's good. So this thing you need to do compulsory, otherwise you can't run your program. So after doing this, you need to have a sample program, okay? Sample yacc or lex program. I have over here, okay? Sample programs. And first, let me show you how to run a lex program, okay? So I guess simplest program is addition is the simplest one. So you have this. What you need to do is you need to first. I think only you will have this .l file. These two other files are produced after you use the commands, okay? So first just go to this like path and put cmd. Okay, so the first command what you need to do use is flex. Okay, flex file name dot l. So our file name is add dot l. So if you just hit enter, then your lex.wav file will be getting generated. Okay, and next command is gcc lex dot yy dot c and hit enter. It will take some time, and after that this executable file will be created. So I've tried this earlier, so my already this lex.wav and a files are already existing. So actually only this .l file will be there. These two files will be created later when you use this command flex add .l gcc lex.wav.c. I hope that makes sense. And after that just click a.exe. okay, and you will be like your program will be getting executed. So here in my program I need to type a, I will ask for a number 10. And I need type B, it will ask for some number, I will put 10, and type C, the sum is 20. So as you can see here, this is the basic lex program and it's working. So this is simple commands, flex name.l, gcc lex.yy.c, and just a.exe. Okay. So now let me show you a yacc program. Okay. So here is a yacc program and I will go with calc this one. So for yacc also it's pretty the same process, just go to the path and hit cmd over here. And now what we are going to do is you need to put bison. Okay, for yacc we will be using bison underscore d, the file name dot y. So for lex it is dot l and for yacc it is dot y. So our file name is calc calc dot y. Okay, hit enter. And our next command is flex file name dot l, so it's going to be calc dot l. Hit enter. Next command is going to be gcc lex dot yy dot c space name, calc is our name here, calc dot tab dot c. Okay, so you'll be getting some warnings. Okay, warning is just common, there isn't any error I guess, so everything is warning, so you can just skip it. And actually same thing over here, we will be having only this dot l and dot y file in the beginning, and all these files will be generated as we run our commands, as we put our commands in our command prompt, all these files will be generated at the end. Our dot application file will be generated at the end, like this command. Okay, where is that? GCC. This command generates our application file. Okay, so after doing this, it's just a.exe. And this one is like calculation, I guess. So if you type sqrt of 16, I will get 4, I think so. Yes, I'm getting 4. So this is the program. So you don't have this program, like you can get this codes from net, okay? Like there are like lot of GitHub links and you can just try it out. In it's also present in Stack Overflow, I guess. So that's it for this video. And mine's a program channel. I run tutorials in C, C++, Python, Java, Blender, Unity. Do check out the YouTube channel and thanks for watching and subscribe to me. Thank you.